Good day, examiners. This time we will going to review professional education focusing in education technology. But before you will going to start, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And now, be ready, let's begin. Number 1. Which of these technologies used in the classroom are arranged from the most symbolic to multisensory? A. Real objects, print, audiovisual materials and visual materials. B. Visual materials, audiovisual materials, print and computers. C. Visual materials, print, audiovisual materials and realia. D. Print, audiovisual materials, computers and realia. Which of these technologies used in the classroom are arranged from the most symbolic to multisensory? A. Real objects, print, audiovisual materials and visual materials. B. Visual materials, audiovisual materials, print and computers. C. Visual materials, print, audiovisual materials and realia. D. Print, audiovisual materials, computers and realia. Number 2. Ms. Hernandez employs student-centered instruction as the learners create their digital portfolios in her computer class. What could be developed among them through this approach? A. Repetition and active learning. B. Mastery of skills and information delivery. C. Information processing and passive learning. D. Construction of knowledge and information exchange. Ms. Hernandez employs student-centered instruction as the learners create their digital portfolios in her computer class. What could be developed among them through this approach? A. Repetition and active learning. B. Mastery of skills and information delivery. C. Information processing and passive learning. D. Construction of knowledge and information exchange. Number 3. Which of the following computer-based instructional materials can be used to learn new concepts? A. Games. B. Tutorial. C. Simulation. D. Drill and practice. Which of the following computer-based instructional materials can be used to learn new concepts? A. Games. B. Tutorial. C. Simulation. D. Drill and practice. Number 4. Which is not a basic consideration in selecting and evaluating the content of an educational technology tool? A. Does it match the content? B. Can it be easily dismantled? C. Will it motivate and maintain interest? D. Is there evidence of its effectiveness? Which is not a basic consideration in selecting and evaluating the content of an educational technology tool? A. Does it match the content? B. Can it be easily dismantled? C. Will it motivate and maintain interest? D. Is there evidence of its effectiveness? Number 5. Which is the most important reason why teachers need to preview their instructional materials that will be used in the class? A. To gain confidence in using them. B. To encourage viewers to be more focused. C. To avoid potential problems that might occur while materials are in use. D. To ensure appropriateness of the materials with the objectives and target audience. Which is the most important reason why teachers need to preview their instructional materials that will be used in the class? A. To gain confidence in using them. B. To encourage viewers to be more focused. C. To avoid potential problems that might occur while materials are in use. D. To ensure appropriateness of the materials with the objectives and target audience. Number 6. You asked your students to show a two-dimensional illustration of what they have understood from what they have read. Which of the following non-projected visuals are you referring to? A. Graphic organizer. B. Print materials. C. Model. D. Realia. You asked your students to show a two-dimensional illustration of what they have understood from what they have read. Which of the following non-projected visuals are you referring to? A. Graphic organizer. B. print materials. C. Model. D. Realia. Number 7. Professor Ruiz uses projected visuals such as digital liquid projector, DLP, in presenting her lesson. What could be her main reason for using it? A. The projected materials are readily available. B. They are more abstract than any other visuals. C. Most projected visuals can be obtained at no cost. D. She can easily prepare for own transparencies in advance. Professor Ruiz uses projected visuals such as digital liquid projector, DLP, in presenting her lesson. What could be her main reason for using it? A. The projected materials are readily available. B. They are more abstract than any other visuals. C. Most projected visuals can be obtained at no cost. D. She can easily prepare for own transparencies in advance. Number 8. Computers can be classified according to the roles they play, namely communicative tool, informative tool, and constructive tool. What is the other role of computers not mentioned in this item? A. Instructional tool. B. Situating tool. C. Utility tool. D. Application tool. Computers can be classified according to the roles they play, namely communicative tool, informative tool, and constructive tool. What is the other role of computers not mentioned in this item? A. Instructional tool. B. Situating tool. C. Utility tool. D. Application tool. Number 9. Which of the following is an ineffective use of presentation software? A. Darken the room. B. Use appropriate pacing. C. Read directly from the slides. D. Allow interaction with the learner. Which of the following is an ineffective use of presentation software? A. Darken the room. B. Use appropriate pacing. C. Read directly from the slides. D. Allow interaction with the learner. Number 10. Why is one-way delivery of information a misuse of communication tools? A. Because the teacher expects the student to study more. B. Because it requires activities that focus on thinking than responding. C. Because it enables the users to focus more on higher-level cognitive activities. D. Because this kind of practice lessens interaction capabilities of communication tools. Why is one-way delivery of information a misuse of communication tools? A. Because the teacher expects the student to study more. B. Because it requires activities that focus on thinking than responding. C. Because it enables the users to focus more on higher-level cognitive activities. D. Because this kind of practice lessens interaction capabilities of communication tools. Number 11. Which technology tool can Professor Soriano use to communicate asynchronously with her students? A. Chat and blog. B. Chat and instant messaging. C. Blog and video conferencing. D. Electronic bulletin board and email. Which technology tool can Professor Soriano use to communicate asynchronously with her students? A. Chat and blog. B. Chat and instant messaging. C. Blog and video conferencing. D. Electronic bulletin board and email. Number 12. Which statement is incorrect about computer conferencing? A. It refers to live student interaction with an expert. B. It is also known as discussion forum or bulletin board. C. It also refers to online class discussions, forums or debates. D. It permits two or more individuals. Which statement is incorrect about computer conferencing? A. It refers to live student interaction with an expert. B. It is also known as discussion forum or bulletin board. C. It also refers to online class discussions, forums or debates. D. It permits two or more individuals. Number 13. When is distance education as effective as the traditional instruction? A. When the method, technologist and assessment used are appropriate to the required competencies. B. When the course requires more face-to-face communication between the students and teachers. C. When students depend more on their online mentor. D. When there is student-to-student interaction. When is distance education as effective as the traditional instruction? A. When the method, technologist and assessment used are appropriate to the required competencies. B. When the course requires more face-to-face communication between the students and teachers. C. When students depend more on their online mentor. D. When there is student-to-student interaction. Number 14. Which of the following statements has a very limited definition of educational technology? A. It is a profession composed of various job categories. B. It refers to the computers used for teaching and learning. C. It includes audiovisual materials, interactive multimedia and self-instructional materials. D. It is the development, application and evaluation of system, techniques and aids to improve human learning. Which of the following statements has a very limited definition of educational technology? A. It is a profession composed of various job categories. B. It refers to the computers used for teaching and learning. C. It includes audiovisual materials, interactive multimedia and self-instructional materials. D. It is the development, application and evaluation of system, techniques and aids to improve human learning. Number 15. Ms. Gomez is planning to integrate technology in her mathematics class. Which of the following would be the logical steps in doing this? 1. Set the objectives. 2. Analyze the learners. 3. Utilize the materials with showmanship. 4. Evaluate the performance of the students. A. 1, 2, 3, 4. B. 2, 1, 3, 4. Circa 1, 2, 4, 3. D. 2, 1, 4, 3. Ms. Gomez is planning to integrate technology in her mathematics class. Which of the following would be the logical steps in doing this? 1. Set the objectives. 2. Analyze the learners. 3. Utilize the materials with showmanship. 4. Evaluate the performance of the students. A. 1, 2, 3. 4. B. 2, 1, 3, 4. Circa 1, 2, 4, 3. D. 2, 1, 4, 3. Number 16. Mrs. Olivares presented real samples of rocks in her general science class. What principle did she apply? A. Appropriateness. B. Authenticity. C. Responsiveness. D. Simplicity. Mrs. Olivares presented real samples of rocks in her general science class. What principle did she apply? A. Appropriateness. B. Authenticity. C. Responsiveness. D. Simplicity. Number 17. Which of the following should Mr. Rivera primarily consider in determining the teaching-learning objectives and use of instructional media? A. The assessment tool to be used. B. The learning activities. C. The learner. D. The teacher. Which of the following should Mr. Rivera primarily consider in determining the teaching-learning objectives and use of instructional media? A. The assessment tool to be used. B. The learning activities. C. The learner. D. The teacher. Number 18. Mr. Rosales, an ICT teacher, takes into account technology standards to address the needs of the students and help them adapt with the changing society and technology. Which of the following standards is an exception? A. Creativity and innovation. B. Research and information literacy. C. Model digital age work and learning. D. Technology operations and concepts. Mr. Rosales, An ICT teacher takes into account technology standards to address the needs of the students and help them adapt with the changing society and technology. Which of the following standards is an exception? A. Creativity and innovation. B. Research and information literacy. C. Model digital age work and learning. D. Technology operations and concepts. Number 19. Ms. Dabuga, a computer teacher, demonstrates understanding of local and global issues and exhibits ethical and legal use of information and communications technology tools. Which is true about her? A. She models digital age work and learning. B. She facilitates and inspires student learning and creativity. C. She promotes and models digital citizenship and responsibility. D. She designs and develops digital age learning experiences and assessments. Ms. Dabuga, a computer teacher, demonstrates understanding of local and global issues and exhibits ethical and legal use of information and communications technology tools. Which is true about her? A. She models digital age work and learning. B. She facilitates and inspires student learning and creativity. C. She promotes and models digital citizenship and responsibility. D. She designs and develops digital age learning experiences and assessments. Number 20. Mrs. Sisson would like to integrate technology in writing a friendly letter. Which of the following is the most effective way of doing it? A. Let the pupils surf a friendly letter from the internet. B. Have the pupils write a friendly letter and send it through an email. C. Have the pupils forward a downloaded friendly letter to others via email. D. Let the pupils write a friendly letter using word processing and have it critiqued by their peers. Mrs. Sisson would like to integrate technology in writing a friendly letter. Which of the following is the most effective way of doing it? A. Let the pupils surf a friendly letter from the internet. B. Have the pupils write a friendly letter and send it through an email. C. Have the pupils forward a downloaded friendly letter to others via email. D. Let the pupils write a friendly letter using word processing and have it critiqued by their peers. Number 21. Miss De Los Santos is a fresh graduate teacher who was hired to teach in an elementary school where there are enough resources for instruction. She wanted to start preparing her instructional materials. Which is the most systematic process in doing this? A. Design, utilization, evaluation, development. B. Design, development, utilization, evaluation. C. Development, design, utilization, evaluation. D. Development, utilization, evaluation, design. Miss De Los Santos is a fresh graduate teacher who was hired to teach in an elementary school where there are enough resources for instruction. She wanted to start preparing her instructional materials. Which is the most systematic process in doing this? A. Design, utilization, evaluation, development. B. Design, development, utilization, evaluation. C. Development, design, utilization, evaluation. D. Development, utilization, evaluation, design. Number 22. With increasing use of educational technology inside the classroom, what role is expected of the teacher? A. Facilitator. B. Researcher. C. Knowledge giver. D. Source of information. With increasing use of educational technology inside the classroom, what role is expected of the teacher? A. Facilitator. B. Researcher. C. Knowledge giver. D. Source of information. Number 23. There are several reasons why teachers are reluctant in using electronic media in the teaching learning process. Which is the most common reason? A. The limited exposure of teachers to new equipment. B. Their incompatibility to diverse needs of the learners. C. The difficulty in integrating technology in the curriculum. D. The excessive availability of local technology in the community. There are several reasons why teachers are reluctant in using electronic media in the teaching-learning process. Which is the most common reason? A. The limited exposure of teachers to new equipment. B. Their incompatibility to diverse needs of the learners. C. The difficulty in integrating technology in the curriculum. D. The excessive availability of local technology in the community. Number 24. Plants, pebbles, and blocks are just some of the effective instructional materials readily found in the environment if they are utilized properly. Which of the following is incorrect about their classroom use? A. Pass a single object around the class. B. Familiarize yourself with the object or model before its actual utilization. C. Use the objects as springboard in encouraging students' active participation. D. Make sure that the realia and model are large enough to be seen by the whole class. Plants, pebbles, and blocks are just some of the effective instructional materials readily found in the environment if they are utilized properly. Which of the following is incorrect about their classroom use? A. Pass a single object around the class. B. Familiarize yourself with the object or model before its actual utilization. C. Use the objects as springboard in encouraging students' active participation. D. Make sure that the realia and model are large enough to be seen by the whole class. Number 25. Your principal purchased new computer units for your learning resource center. Which of the following should be your last consideration in using the technology? A. Computers can be used for entertainment. B. Computers can be used for research activity. C. Computers can be used for interactive presentation. D. Computers can be used to reinforce discussion of difficult concepts in class. Your principal purchased new computer units for your learning resource center. Which of the following should be your last consideration in using the technology? A. Computers can be used for entertainment. B. Computers can be used for research activity. C. Computers can be used for interactive presentation. D. Computers can be used to reinforce discussion of difficult concepts in class. Number 26. Which of the following is not an example of a communicative tool? A. Chat. B. Electronic mail. C. Teleconferencing. D. Multimedia encyclopedia. Which of the following is not an example of a communicative tool? A. Chat. B. Electronic mail. C. Teleconferencing. D. Multimedia encyclopedia. Number 27. In your computer subject, you allow your class to chat as part of your motivation before discussing to them the roles of computer as a tool. How is chat used in THIS context? A. Information tool. B. Application tool. C. Communicative tool. D. Situating tool. In your computer subject, you allow your class to chat as part of your motivation before discussing to them the roles of computer as a tool. How is chat used in THIS context? A. Information tool. B. Application tool. C. Communicative tool. D. Situating tool. Number 28. In the delivery of distance education, what computer application is used to organize instructions and track students' records and progress? A. Computer-based multimedia. B. Computer-assisted instruction. C. Computer-mediated education. D. Computer-managed instruction. In the delivery of distance education, what computer application is used to organize instructions and track students' records and progress? A. Computer-based multimedia. B. Computer-assisted instruction. C. Computer-mediated education. D. Computer-managed instruction. Number 29. Which of the following statements is correct about the domains of educational technology? A. Design is the production stage while development is the planning stage. B. Both the design and development are the planning stage. C. Evaluation is synonymous with implementation. D. Utilization is the action phase. Which of the following statements is correct about the domains of educational technology? A. Design is the production stage while development is the planning stage. B. Both the design and development are the planning stage. C. Evaluation is synonymous with implementation. D. Utilization is the action phase. Number 30. Which group of technologies has the highest degree of concreteness? A. Realia and computer. B. Video, picture and television. C. Digital video, film, versatile compact disc. D. Book, imaginative literature, programmed instruction. Which group of technologies has the highest degree of concreteness? A. Realia and computer. B. Video, picture and television. C. Digital video, film, versatile compact disc. D. Book, imaginative literature, programmed instruction. Number 31. Which is the best reason why teachers state the objectives before using instructional media? A. To secure materials. B. To prepare the materials beforehand. C. To determine which media to use best. D. To be able to practice how to operate the equipment. Which is the best reason why teachers state the objectives before using instructional media? A. To secure materials. B. To prepare the materials beforehand. C. To determine which media to use best. D. To be able to practice how to operate the equipment. Number 32. Susan wants to learn more English. Specifically, she wants to improve her listening skills. She has a CD player, a tape recorder, and has internet access. As an English teacher, what do you suggest? 1. CDs with English listening drills. 2. Tapes with English listening drills. 3. Internet websites such as Go4English, English Language Listening Lab, or Randall's Listening Lab. A. 1 and 2. B. 2 and 3. Circa 1 or 3. D. 1, 2 and 3. Susan wants to learn more English. Specifically, she wants to improve her listening skills. She has a CD player, a tape recorder, and has internet access. As an English teacher, what do you suggest? 1. CDs with English listening drills. 2. Tapes with English listening drills. 3. Internet websites such as Go4English, English Language Listening Lab, or Randall's Listening Lab. A. 1 and 2. B. 2 and 3. Circa 1 or 3. D. 1, 2 and 3. Number 33. Computers can be classified according to the roles they play, namely communicative tool, informative tool, and constructive tool. What is the other role of computers not mentioned in this item? A. Instructional tool. B. Situating tool. C. Utility tool. D. Application tool. Computers can be classified according to the roles they play, namely communicative tool, informative tool, and constructive tool. What is the other role of computers not mentioned in this item? A. Instructional tool. B. Situating tool. C. Utility tool. D. Application tool. Number 34. Professor Delacruz would like to create a presentation material for her lesson on the types of computer-assisted instruction. To make her presentation effective, which? A. Situating tool. B. Informative tool. C. Productivity tool. D. Communicative tool. Professor Delacruz would like to create a presentation material for her lesson on the types of computer-assisted instruction. To make her presentation effective, which? A. Situating tool. B. Informative tool. C. Productivity tool. D. Communicative tool. Number 35. Your father wanted to finish his long-dreamed course, but he wanted to do it at home during his free time. Would you recommend an online learning? A. Yes, because online learning is the in thing. B. No, because online learning inhibits student-teacher interaction. C. No, because hiring a helper would enable him to attend regularly in his class. D. Yes, because he could learn at his own pace using a wide spectrum of technologies. Your father wanted to finish his long-dreamed course, but he wanted to do it at home during his free time. Would you recommend an online learning? A. Yes, because online learning is the in thing. B. No, because online learning inhibits student-teacher interaction. C. No, because hiring a helper would enable him to attend regularly in his class. D. Yes, because he could learn at his own pace using a wide spectrum of technologies. Number 36. Professor Balagtas used worksheets, manipulatives, and models in teaching math to help her students understand the lessons and love the subject. What did she bear in mind when she used these materials? A. Appropriateness. B. Balance. C. Breadth. D. Variety. Professor Balagtas used worksheets, manipulatives, and models in teaching math to help her students understand the lessons and love the subject. What did she bear in mind when she used these materials? A. Appropriateness. B. Balance. C. Breadth. D. Variety. Number 37. Professor Mandanas would like to use an audio compact disc in teaching a lesson in Filipino. In which activity in the teaching learning process is it very effective? A. In developing listening skills. B. In teaching creating thinking. C. In composing poems. D. In building concepts. Professor Mandanas would like to use an audio compact disc in teaching a lesson in Filipino. In which activity in the teaching learning process is it very effective? A. In developing listening skills. B. In teaching creating thinking. C. In composing poems. D. In building concepts. Number 38. Which of the following categories of CAI will you use in your class if your objective is to increase proficiency in a newly learned skill or refresh an existing one? A. Tutorial. B. Simulation. C. Drill and practice. D. Instructional game. Which of the following categories of CAI will you use in your class if your objective is to increase proficiency in a newly learned skill or refresh an existing one? A. Tutorial. B. Simulation. C. Drill and practice. D. Instructional game. Number 39. Which instructional application will you introduce to your class if your objective is to help them find and use information resources available in the internet? A. WebQuests. B. Hybrid Course. C. Scavenger Hunt. D. Distance Education. Which instructional application will you introduce to your class if your objective is to help them find and use information resources available in the internet? A. WebQuests. B. Hybrid Course. C. Scavenger Hunt. D. Distance Education. Number 40. Which of the following is a limitation of models and real objects in teaching and learning? A. They pose problems on storage. B. They make learning more concrete. C. They provide hands-on learning experiences. D. They are readily available in the environment, around school and in the home. Which of the following is a limitation of models and real objects in teaching and learning? A. They pose problems on storage. B. They make learning more concrete. C. They provide hands-on learning experiences. D. They are readily available in the environment, around school and in the home. Number 41. Mrs. Del Prado placed text together with the relevant graphics on the same page in her multimedia presentation. Which principle did she apply? A. Split attention. B. Spatial contiguity. C. Cost effectiveness. D. Communication effectiveness. Mrs. Del Prado placed text together with the relevant graphics on the same page in her multimedia presentation. Which principle did she apply? A. Split attention. B. Spatial contiguity. C. Cost effectiveness. D. Communication effectiveness. Number 42. Which of the following technologies provide iconic experiences to students and children? A. Video and books. B. Pictures and videos. C. Radio and recording. D. Modules and periodicals. Which of the following technologies provide iconic experiences to students and children? A. Video and books. B. Pictures and videos. C. Radio and recording. D. Modules and periodicals. Number 43. Which of the following is inappropriate in using printed visuals such as charts, graphs, and drawings? A. Provide written or verbal cues to highlight important aspect of visuals. B. Present the instructional materials simultaneously. C. Use materials that everyone can see. D. Make the presentation suspenseful. Which of the following is inappropriate in using printed visuals such as charts, graphs, and drawings? A. Provide written or verbal cues to highlight important aspect of visuals. B. Present the instructional materials simultaneously. C. Use materials that everyone can see. D. Make the presentation suspenseful. Number 44. Which of the following statements is incorrect about the contributions of technology to student learning? A. The quality of learning can be improved. B. The delivery of instruction can be more interesting. C. The method of teaching and learning becomes more interactive. D. The role of a teacher can be changed into knowledge dispenser. Which of the following statements is incorrect about the contributions of technology to student learning? A. The quality of learning can be improved. B. The delivery of instruction can be more interesting. C. The method of teaching and learning becomes more interactive. D. The role of the teacher can be changed into knowledge dispenser. Number 45. Mr. Torres will have a multimedia presentation in his science class. Which of the following should he avoid? A. Consider technical quality. B. Apply different computer effects per slide. C. Present information through graphic organizers. D. Use contrasting colors for text and background. Mr. Torres will have a multimedia presentation in his science class. Which of the following should he avoid? A. Consider technical quality. B. Apply different computer effects per slide. C. Present information through graphic organizers. D. Use contrasting colors for text and background. Number 46. Professor Reyes is thinking of an online learning approach by which content provides links to information at other locations and serves as a focal point for a distance education experience. Which of the following should she use? A. Teleconferencing. B. Self-paced program. C. Web-based instruction. D. Computer-aided instruction. Professor Reyes is thinking of an online learning approach by which content provides links to information at other locations and serves as a focal point for a distance education experience. Which of the following should she use? A. Teleconferencing. B. Self-paced program. C. Web-based instruction. D. Computer-aided instruction. Number 47. After Ms. Rivas planned her lesson in English, she found out that the materials at hand do not match her objectives. Which is the best thing that she can do? A. Modify the available materials. B. Teach the lesson the following day. C. Change the objectives to match with available materials. D. Carry out the lesson as planned and use the materials at hand. After Ms. Rivas planned her lesson in English, she found out that the materials at hand do not match her objectives. Which is the best thing that she can do? A. Modify the available materials. B. Teach the lesson the following day. C. Change the objectives to match with available materials. D. Carry out the lesson as planned and use the materials at hand. Number 48. It is impractical to bring real objects to the classroom, so Aaron constructed a three-dimensional visual instead. Which of the following did he construct? A. Chart. B. Cartoon. C. Model. D. Graphic organizer. It is impractical to bring real objects to the classroom, so Aaron constructed a three-dimensional visual instead. Which of the following did he construct? A. Chart. B. Cartoon. C. Model. D. Graphic organizer. Number 49. Miss Simondi used a film clip in teaching social studies concepts to her first year high school class. However, she found out that it was ineffectively used in the classroom. When is technology considered ineffective? A. When it promotes mastery of the lesson. B. When it makes viewing more interesting. C. When it helps attain the objectives of the lesson. D. When it induces alienation on the part of the learners. Miss Simondi used a film clip in teaching social studies concepts to her first year high school class. However, she found out that it was ineffectively used in the classroom. When is technology considered ineffective? A. When it promotes mastery of the lesson. B. When it makes viewing more interesting. C. When it helps attain the objectives of the lesson. D. When it induces alienation on the part of the learners. Number 50. Internet consists of thousands of connected computer networks around the world. Which term does not refer to internet? A. Net. B. Online. C. Cyberspace. D. Information superhighway. Internet consists of thousands of connected computer networks around the world. Which term does not refer to internet? A. Net. B. Online. C. Cyberspace. D. Information superhighway.